I want to give some updates on our priority areas. Our priorities haven't changed since last year. The two major technological waves driving our roadmap are AI today and over the longer term, the metaverse. So first, let's talk about our AI discovery engine. Facebook and Instagram are shifting from being organized solely around people and accounts you follow to increasingly showing more relevant content recommended by our AI systems. And this covers every content format, which is something that makes our services unique. But we're especially focused on short-form video since Reels is growing so quickly. And I'm really proud of our progress here. You know, Reels plays across Facebook and Instagram have more than doubled over the last year, while the social component of people resharing Reels has grown even faster and has more than doubled on both apps in just the last 6 months. The next bottleneck that we're focused on to continue growing Reels is improving monetization efficiency, or the revenue that's generated per minute of Reels watched. Currently, the monetization efficiency of Reels is much less than Feed. So the more that Reels grows, even though it adds engagement to the system overall, it takes some time away from Feed and we actually lose money. But people want to see more Reels though. So, you know, the key to unlocking that is improving our monetization efficiency so that way we can show more Reels without losing increasing amounts of money. We're making progress here, and our monetization efficiency on Facebook has doubled in the past 6 months. In terms of the revenue headwind, we're still on track to be roughly neutral by the end of this year or maybe early next year. And then after that, we should be able to profitably grow Reels while keeping up with the demand that we see. In our broader ads business, we're continuing to invest in AI, and we're seeing our efforts pay off here. In the last quarter, advertisers saw over 20% more conversions than in the year before, and combined with a declining cost per acquisition, this has resulted in higher returns on ad spend. We continue to be excited about the monetization opportunity with business messaging too. Facebook and Instagram are the first two pillars of our business, and in the next few years, we hope to bring messaging online as the next pillar. One way of doing this is click-to-message ads, which is now at a $10 billion run rate. And paid messaging is the other piece of this. We're earlier here, but we continue to onboard more businesses to the WhatsApp business platform where they can answer customer questions, send updates, and sell directly in chat. So for example, Air France started using WhatsApp to share boarding passes and other information, other flight information in 22 countries and four languages. And businesses often tell us that more people open their messages and they get better results on WhatsApp than other channels. AI, it's the foundation of our discovery engine and our ads business. And we also think that it's going to enable many new products and additional transformations in our apps. Generative AI is an extremely exciting new area with so many different applications. And one of my goals for Meta is to build on our research to become a leader in generative AI in addition to our leading work in recommendation AI. So the last area that I want to talk about is the metaverse. We shipped Quest Pro at the end of last year. I'm really proud of it. It's the first mainstream mixed reality device. And we are setting the standard for the industry with our Meta Reality system. Now, as always, the reason why we're focused on building these platforms is to deliver better social experiences than what's possible today on phones. And the value of MR is that you can experience the immersion and presence of VR while still being grounded in the physical world around you. We're already seeing developers build out some impressive new experiences like Nanome for 3D modeling, molecules and drug development, Arkeo for architects and designers to create interiors, and of course, a lot of great games. The MR ecosystem is relatively new, but I think it's going to grow a lot over the next few years. Later this year, we're going to launch our next generation consumer headset, which will feature Meta Reality as well. And I expect that this is going to establish this technology as the baseline for all headsets going forward, and eventually, of course, for AR glasses as well. Beyond MR, the broader VR ecosystem continues growing. There are now over 200 apps on our VR devices that have made more than $1 million in revenue. We're also continuing to make progress with avatars. We just launched avatars on WhatsApp last quarter, and more than 100 million people have already created avatars in the app. And of those, about 1 in 5 are using their avatar as their WhatsApp profile photo. And I thought that was an interesting example of how the family of apps and metaverse visions come together. Because, you know, even though most of our Reality Labs investment is going towards future computing platforms, glasses, headsets, and the software to run them, as the technology develops, most people are going to experience the metaverse for the first time on phones and start building up their digital identities across our apps.
The first one's on generative AI. Sort of wanted to dig a little more into how you think about, you know, your blue sky potential user and advertiser use cases of generative AI. And how do you think about the timeline when we can first see some glimpses of those on the platform? And then the second one for Susan, just any more color on the new data center architecture and how we should think about the long-term capital intensity of the business, whether it's CapEx per minute, CapEx per DAU, how big of a long-term benefit could this change be to the overall cash flow? Thanks.
Yeah, I can start with generative AI. You know, I think this is a really exciting area. And I mean, I'd say, you know, the two biggest themes that, you know, focused on for this year, and one is efficiency, and then the kind of the new product area is going to be the generative AI work. We have a bunch of different work streams across almost every single one of our products to use the new technologies, especially the large language models and diffusion models for generating images and videos and avatars and 3D assets and all kinds of different stuff across all the different work streams that we're working on. As well as over the long term, you know, working on things that could really empower creators to be way more productive and creative across the apps, and, you know, run a lot of different accounts. So I know there's some really exciting stuff here. I want to be careful not to kind of get too far ahead of the development of it. So I think you'll see us launch a number of different things this year, and we'll talk about them, and we'll share updates on how they're doing. I do expect that the space will move quickly. I think we'll learn a lot about what works and what doesn't. A lot of the stuff is expensive, right, to kind of generate an image or a video or, you know, a chat interaction. You know, these things we're talking about, like cents or fraction of a cent. So one of the big interesting challenges here also is going to be, how do we scale this and make this work more efficient so we can bring it to a much larger user base. But I think once we do that, there are going to be a number of very exciting use cases. I realize this is a pretty high level answer for now, but I think that we'll be able to share more details over the coming months.